Hi, I'm Suzanne Smiley with Atlas RFID, and we're here at the SMARTRAC booth at RFID Journal Live 2014. I'm here with Kelly Snead. How are you doing today?
I'm doing excellent. How about you?
Well, good. We love that tie.
Thank you.
Great look on you.
Thank you.
We're here to learn what they have at the Journal, what they have at Journal Live, and what you have going on at SMARTRAC this year.
SMARTRAC, we're really excited. We've got a couple of new introductions. We're starting to look at the new Monza R6 chip.
Yes.
Starting out with some new designs, we were the first one to release a 20 by 40 chip.
Really?
Better performance, better durability, so we're really excited about that.
Okay.
We're also really excited about all of our inlays and
yes,
transponders, our dog bones, our short dipoles, which y'all are doing a fantastic job getting out into the marketplace. We appreciate it. Again, we lead the industry in inlay manufacturing and production. Our yields are very, very high, the highest in the industry, we feel like. We also are into our NFC tags,
right,
which are becoming very popular in many, many applications that we're seeing there as well.
Yeah, we're seeing them become more and more popular where the UHF are just constantly,
constant
sellers.
And we keep growing our UHF business.
Mm-hmm.
We're seeing more and more retail applications, industrial applications, closed loop controls.
Wow.
So a lot of different applications for UHF as well.
Well, great. So you got your dog bones here, your NFC tags, and then what do we have over here?
Well, SMARTRAC is also a manufacturer of card prelams.
Okay.
We can do LF, HF, UHF, and we can also do dual frequency cards.
Wow.
We manufacture and have patented technology into the prelam materials, which can be made into cards.
Okay.
With card manufacturers. We also offer a standard white card that can go straight to your customers and go straight through a Zebra printer or some similar type printer to be used for access or for entertainment, hospitality, things like that.
Okay, great. And so those are just standard cards that you can put through that Zebra printer and get going immediately.
Yeah, you can print and get going immediately, correct.
What kind of inlay do you have for those?
Well, these are typically the inlays that we put in there. So from a UHF standpoint, we have standard designs that would go into the UHF.
Okay.
For HF, either for 14443, then we're working on an NFC version for the cards as well. And
wow,
then we actually have the dual frequency, which might be used for, say, to gain access into a trade show like this,
right,
for a UHF standpoint for long distance reads.
Mm-hmm.
But then you have the HF or the NFC portion of it that you might be able to use to purchase products or to gain access into,
right,
a door or to your hotel room or something like,
right,
that.
Right, to gain information for a smaller tag.
Well, for access.
For
so
access,
you have,
right,
the NFC for machine-to-machine communications.
Mm-hmm.
But the UHF for long distance reads.
Exactly.
So we're seeing that combination in hotel and in entertainment industry where,
mm-hmm,
people want to look and see where gain people access on a long range scale,
right,
but then have them have personal information, or not personal information, but be able to use it for personal access or to purchase products or things like that.
Wow. Okay, well, what else have y'all got at the booth? Can we go around and see what else y'all have?
We have a few other items. We've got some products from Korea that we're looking at pharmaceuticals and how to track and trace pharmaceuticals.
Cool.
It's a neat inventory. We're seeing a lot more companies doing pharmaceutical or healthcare tracking and tracing, from reagents to medicines to things being used in the medical machines themselves.
Okay.
So with RFID and the unique TID indicator or unique UID,
mm-hmm,
we're seeing that traceability and that tracking being able to be done, and linking that to either a particular sample or at least through traceability.
Right.
Very,
okay,
important.
And so you just
very
stick
important
them on there?
Well, typically these are placed inside the caps or inside the boxes.
Okay.
And we're showing one of our partners' software from that application, and this is out of Korea.
Well, that's awesome.
So they're able to detect, you know, where this drug is coming from, where it's going to,
where
patients,
it's
where it's been.
Right.
Like,
talk more about the specific tags that you have in your hand right now. So you've got a dog bone tag, right?
We have a dog bone tag, and typically this tag is used for pallet and for assets. This is a fairly large tag, but,
mm-hmm,
but generally industry is using this tag to get very far reads.
Right.
We actually can do all kinds of applications, but it's a pallet type of application or a very long read. We literally make thousands of different inlays, and I was actually going to find these in here.
Okay. Yeah, here are packs that
Here's a pack of inlays, and I'll open these up and show you a couple of inlays out of this, if that'll be all right.
Yes.
When you absolutely, positively have to find something, we always turn to our frog. This is our 3x3 frog. This is a dual dipole, which means we can turn this tag in any orientation, and it'll pick up. It actually has two antennas on it.
Okay.
This tag is being used in a lot of warehouse applications where you have one big reader that's looking at the entire warehouse.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason why they like it is because typically they don't know how the tag is going to hang
and orient.
Right. So this is our true long distance tag that we have.
Cool.
We also We also have our bread and butter tag, which is our short dipole. This is our Monza 5 product that y'all currently carry.
Sell a lot of.
We're using this a lot for just individual item tagging, case and pallet. Usually when I start an application, this is the tag that I start with.
Your go-to?
This is my go-to.
Okay.
And then we can go either way from there. So
really?
It's really about footprint size. So if you have the footprint to be able to start with this is where I would start.
And that's been great with our race timing community as well for tagging bibs, and they've been using it, nonstop. It's been just the industry go-to for race timing.
Oh, cool. It's been a go-to tag for us for many years.
Okay.
Now, in the retail segment, I'll give you this one.
All right.
In the retail segment, we go to a little bit smaller tag, if I can get these out real quick. This is called our belt.
Oh, okay.
And our belt tag is designed a little bit smaller. It's similar to the short dipole.
Mm-hmm.
And this tag is just made a little bit shorter so that it can go into the hang tags on shirts or apparel. And this has been a very popular tag. And again, not much loss in performance because it's just a little bit shorter than the short dipole. And really just made because of the footprint size of the tag.
That's what I was going to say. So it's a smaller size tag.
Correct.
Great.
Correct.
Okay, great.
And then
as you get
down a little bit further, we actually have products such as our mini web or our web light, which is a smaller form factor for accessories.
Okay.
Again, size in the RFID antenna is going to determine your performance.
Right.
Typically, but it's also about tuning the tag for the application.
Mm-hmm.
We try to make our tags very wide banded so that they perform well across a whole variety of dielectrics that you put this on.
Wow.
But if you can go with the larger tag, you can get longer reads.
Okay.
But most of the time, in smaller items, we're limited to what the size tag you can put on there.
Right.
So this tag might be in use for a box that size, where a bigger tag can't be used.
Can't be used, right.
Correct.
So
correct.
That is awesome.
So we have literally thousands of different inlays, different form factors we can offer and offer through you.
Right.
We can offer the clear, or we can PET or the paper face version.
Or the wet inlay.
Or the wet inlay, whatever you need.
All right, that sounds so good. Thank you so much for taking
us through the
booth. We've really had a great time here. So any last words on SmartTrack in general?
No, I just want to, we are, again, probably one of the world's leader in RFID technology. We're based on about 15 different countries with sales and service organizations. We have many different factories around the world in six different countries.
Wow.
We continue to be a leader in government, in the cards. We do the passport covers for the U.S. passports in many other countries. A leader in the card business, as well as the tag and inlay business.
Definitely. Well, thank you so much, Kelly. We always love coming by SmartTrack. And I hope you have a good rest of the day, a great end to RFID Journal Live 2014.
Thank you so much.